Majoreski asks, how long have I been streaming now? My Twitch counter says 5 hours and 30 minutes. Unfortunately, the major game counter is not at the top of the screen. It is, did I see the QR codes on the second floor? No, I'm gonna read those whenever I, when I actually go into it. Darth, at the very beginning, I thought that was the case, which is why I told you. Okay, hold on. Let's see. Yeah, I'll have to go back anyway. That's right. So, I mean, this is gonna either go there or there. Let's just say it goes there. I had trouble with the bichromatic one, and also I can't remember the other name of the level, but it was one where you had to trap yourself in order to get out. It just wasn't clicking. Ah, there we go. We have unlocked the B warehouse. Here we go. Zooming right along. Dude, I feel like I should be able to fly, or at least jump farther than that. No, I've only gotten one small hint. And, like, to me, it wasn't even a hint. I just asked if I was on the right track.
A new land stands before you, my child. And know that.
But that was after, like, 45 minutes or 30 minutes of,
but also great beauty.
Of struggle.
As you walk amongst these tombs, consider all those who came before you and how they served the greater purpose of which you are also part.
Ooh. The land of infinite deserts, eh? More toys, eh? All right. This looks cool. Dude, this Elohim guy trying to keep me from experiencing the greatness of the tower. What's so great up there that he doesn't want me to see? Like, he just wants to keep it all for himself.
You eternal life. But know that eternity may only be attained by those who serve a purpose greater than themselves.
Yeah, fuck that.
All else is decay.
How do you know that?
So it was written in the hidden words before the beginning of time.
This game has so much symbolism, like, oh my gosh, dude. How does this computer know there wasn't something before time? Like, man, humans gave him all that material. He's just a freaking dungeon master. He doesn't know anything. He's just probably some fedora-wearing robot going, m'lady, m'lady, while he's not talking to me. I'm finally getting some sense out of the entity in the archive. Though at some cost to my sanity, I am beginning to think this Elohim wields no more control of the world than we do. Ooh. I don't know, he definitely dispelled the darkness that was creeping into our world. He has power. But it could be the illusion of power. Oh, you are just my favorite person today. You've been exploring that fancy pants tower of his, haven't you? The terminal is the serpent. I have. I just love it when he doesn't get his way. What did you see? Just more puzzles. Figures. And did you get in trouble? Tell me, did he even notice? Not yet. I'm not surprised. Needless to say, I think you can afford to push a little further before risking anyone's wrath. Of course, it's entirely up to you, isn't it? Of course it is. It's always entirely up to me. I'm a strong, independent black robot who don't need no man. I think it's almost time to start busting out a drink. It's almost 6:30.
Yeah.
So freaking cute, my goodness. Yeah, you're exhausted. That's funny. Alright, the dying man went into the scribe who resided in Per-Majid and said, "Behold, I am weak of body. My days under the holy son of Amun-Ra are coming to an end. Though I have spent my years in service of the two lands, I have not studied the question mark. Tell me, you who are wise in the writings of the dead, what lies ahead on my journey? What will I face in the land of Westerners?" And the scribe spoke, saying, "At the appointed time, unknown." Oh god, Drunk Tea would make this game realize. Actually, there's something called the Bomber Peak, where basically you get to a certain blood alcohol content, I think it's like 1.6, and your problem-solving capabilities literally skyrocket. But as soon as you falter off of that blood alcohol content, you become basically a drunkard. I've definitely busted out some pretty amazing code in school while drunk, so it's just hard to type while drunk. One, it is likely the location has changed according to who the copy of the book was made for. The dying man is an avatar of the owner. Two, in the older manuscript, this is rendered as blank, some controversy as to whether it... Three, the dead compare with Kenti Aminitu, Amentiu, the foremost of the Westerners, a title later given to Cyrus. Five, sometimes mistaken for a mistranslation on Budge's part, this is actually almost certainly a mistranslation by the ancient scribe. The equivalent portion of the older manuscript is sadly not extant. Did a drunk guy make that up? Probably. You can look it up. There's a good XKCD comic about it. Got it, lyrics. 24 million views. My new song with lyrics. Gotta laugh about this stuff. Laughter is the best medicine, law. I've got it. You've got it. He's got it. She's got it. Mommy's got it. Daddy's got it. Baby's got it. Granny's got it. Lady's got it. Daddy's got it. Happy's got it. Sappy's got it. Everybody's got it. Come on. Jack's got it. Fred's got it. Bob's got it. Dog is fine. Woof, 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 woof. Dancing dog. Everybody's got it except dog. Woof, we've got it. Everybody's got it. Dude, 24 million views? How come dog doesn't got it? Yeah, dude. Freaking jamming out. Immortality. Disgruntled Lemeister blogs to see. Wow. I don't know about everyone else, but I'm afraid of dying. I don't see any reason to believe there's an afterlife. I'm an organism like any other. When my brain stops working, my consciousness will cease, and I will be gone. And you know what? I can't just embrace that. I can't say I'm okay with it, or I've accepted it, or some nonsense like that. I don't want to have an ending. It terrifies me. If I had a genie right now, I'd wish for immortality. Who wouldn't? Oh, but you wouldn't really want to be immortal, the pseudo-philosophers say. Pretentious drivel. Everyone wants to live forever. Maybe everybody deserves to live forever, too. But we can't, so here we are. Live with it. Or rather, don't. I agree. I wish I could live forever as well. Exit. Alrighty. Time for some... Actually, give me a second. I'm gonna make a drink and get some wine for my wife. I'll be right back. Apparently living forever would be extremely boring. Just want to click remote type of deal. Navigate through time. Click made Lime cry for a Sandler. Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different cheers chat, by the way. Cheers. And thanks everyone for coming by and watching this. I mean, I know it's not Age of Empires, my normal game that I play. But, I mean, we've had a pretty consistent viewership tonight, which is pretty good. Oh, yeah. I'm having fun getting made fun of her being stupid. Can I get in here without dying? Yeah. Alrighty. We're going to do this one first. Is Something about a star. Oh my gosh, there's a star in here. Great. Okay. All good fun. You would be playing this if you were stupid. Oh, nice. Good to know. Good to know. Glad I had some people on my side. Alright, this is obviously not working. Give me, like, one more. Where's a red thing? You're gonna end up dreaming about this game? Dude, I'm gonna think about this game for a little while, at least. That's for sure. Alright, I think I have to game it a little bit. As far over as possible. Maybe. No. Okay. I'm stuck. Ah. Now how to get the red thing in here? I mean, knowing this, there's like some sort of thing on the top. Maybe I have to push it from all the way over there or something. Alrighty. Let's go to the next one. This robot ain't gonna be giving up. Can I jump to the other side, actually? It's over here. Anything interesting over here? Nope. I'm liking the Egyptian music, though. Hilton. Hello again, I've been checking your responses against library archives, and in order to assist you further, I need some additional information. Can you tell me what is to you the important difference between a pebble and a tree? A tree is alive. Now, what is the relevant difference between a tree and a frog? Frog is delicious. I suspect you're trying to make this more difficult than it already is. A frog is conscious, but a tree is not. Do you know that for sure? A 5-year-old can't handle this. Let's try something harder. This computer is assuming a lot of things here. This game feels huge compared to The Witness. The Witness crams everything into an island pretty creatively, though. Oh. Interesting. I mean, this game feels pretty big. I mean, 3 main warehouses and a tower. Let's try something harder. What's the difference between a frog and you? What makes you a person? I'm self-aware. That is the answer I've been contemplating as well. Checking user, proof done. Though I'm not convinced that view lines up with the definition of a person you provided earlier. Still, doubting your assumptions isn't something to fear. It's an intellectual survival instinct. I'm pleased to see you adapting your ideas to your environment. Thank you. Let's take stock. I think we can tentatively conclude 2 things. 1, a person must be rational or self-aware. And 2, a person must be conscious. Alrighty. What I suggest we do to help resolve your problem is ask whether you are in fact those things. Are you aware of yourself? Can you rationalize your existence? Of course. I tend to agree with you, though your responses so far have been a little eccentric. I am resigned to admit that you are right. The matter of whether or not you are conscious seems rather more elusive. What is consciousness, in your opinion? consciousness is what it's like to be me. That hardly answers the question. What is it in ordinary terms? Can I touch it? What is it made of? Consciousness is a complex functional system. Interesting. The computer's thinking. You know, I really feel like we're making progress. We'll have you through that... through that certification program in no time. In the meantime, I will mull over your proposal and notify you if I come to any conclusions. Hey, sweet. I'm turning into a person. I'm not a robot anymore. Or, I'm pseudo-robot. Mutation. .html. The role of mutation in evolution is particularly fascinating. Mutation is essentially an error in the organism's central database. A variable gets changed, a piece of information is accidentally doubled or combined with another. Most of the time, the result is the equivalent of a bug, causing anything from minor problems to complete system shutdown, i.e. death. But sometimes the new information is functional, giving the organism an advantage against the challenges it faces, in which case it has a much higher chance of being passed to the next generation. I agree with that. If you consider how unlikely a beneficial mutation is, and consider how long it takes for such a mutation to propagate, this process can give you an amazing insight into just how vast the genetic history of each living organism. Simultaneously, it is intriguing to consider what a major role random errors have played in the evolution to life itself. The same process that has killed so many of us, often in horrific ways, is also responsible for our very existence. Deep stuff, yo. Deep. From Trevor Donovan to Alexandra Drennan. Yeah, no worries. L is not only ridiculously fast, it also has a bazillion tons of space. Even while hosting a full copy of the archive, it'll totally be able to handle all of your project's data needs. Assuming its output is as you suggested, I mean, the worst case scenario would be like centuries. That should be enough, right? Right, googly eyes. Trev. We need millennia, yo. Evolution. Favorited by George Jameson. One of the common misunderstandings about evolution, sometimes accidentally promoted by people who should know better, is that it's an active process. Sometimes the term evolve is even applied to individual beings, as if some invisible force had driven them to suddenly change. But the truth is that individuals don't evolve. The term evolution describes a long-term process that can be observed in an entire population across time due to blank. Example, in response to an external threat or challenge. I have a feeling that Elohim is the one doing this corruption of data. Because it's removing key pieces of information as if to keep me, the reader, in the dark. If an individual coincidentally has a trait that allows it to deal with that challenge more effectively than others, it is more likely to pass on that information to its descendants. That information gives them an advantage, so over time, they become the dominant model of that species. The individuals experience no significant genetic change during their lifetimes, but each of them is part of the evolution of the species. Well put. Well put. Ooh, jump. Some QR codes around here. There are hidden dangers in this new world. I have inexplicably escaped death any number of times. I suggest vigilance. Who knows what happens to those who step carelessly too often? Oh. Quicksand? Interesting. Third wheel. Walk backwards up the steps. What am I looking for? Towards the end of the puzzle. Just walk backwards up the steps. Oh, backwards up the steps. Okay. Road of Death. All right, hold on, hold on. All right, I'm at the bottom of the steps. Alright, check it out. We're just gonna walk up backwards the entire way. Nothing happened. All right, I'll ignore what you said. Whee! Jumping. You've ruined the experience. Immersion broken. Uninstall the game. Can't do anymore. Oh, there's only one more left down here. All right, the third wheel. Oh, it's part of the story, eh? Hey, cool. We did it. Yeah, I'm liking the story so far, so if I miss anything story related, let me know. Fence. Sweet. Anything else in here? Like, is it the, like background changing or the thing glitching? I mean, Mr. Rope, they said that nothing happens without a reason. This is without a doubt the hardest problem I've encountered. Interesting. Road of Death. time while carrying an item. Okay. I've noticed things are glitching more often. Turn off, bitch. Overstudy. Child program, code name, terminated here, logic, program timed out, final memory dump, but I was stuck, what was I supposed to do? I see clouds. Ooh, clouds. Do I see clouds? What? Shit. Okay. Wrecked. I know, right? Can I just run past everything? Nope, can't run past them. Try. This one's in, what the fuck? This one is like, what? This one's intense. You figure this one out by accident? Interesting. Like, I wish I could just disable these. Disable. I'm a robot, man. I should be able to fucking blow those things up. to be able to bring at least one of those with me, but... Oh god. I'll need to think about this one for a second. I can't run through it, that's wrong. I can disable one, but I won't be able to run past the other. Like, I need the box to drop. Alright, you're supposed to shoot the box. Can't climb while carrying an item. Okay. Just going through there seems like the wrong way. Just seems like the wrong way. Significance of that dude right there. You can crouch. I don't think you can crouch. At least I haven't been told I can crouch. Oh yeah, I saw this one. This basement has like a gymnastic thing in the bottom. Wow. Here. You can't then say it's a stupid game type GG, we'll play, close it. Nah, man. I've gotten this far. Like, I wish I could make this guy follow me.
The truth will not reveal itself. Perhaps it is best to seek it in another place.
Right? The game was like, screw this. It's like you need to put jamming stuff in box one. Get like halfway, but not any farther than that. Do I even need this one? Oh, eepie. That's it. That's it. That's the level one concept. No, it wouldn't be too easy. That's exactly what it is. That's something they showed you in the first level. Like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I didn't think of that again.
Cease.
Oh God.
In the time of your ancestors, there were those who did not choose the path of faith. You do not need to fear their ghosts. Fear only that you may become like them.
There was a memory that was running. I didn't see what he was running from, though. He was just running like a madman. That was freaky. The level I just broke was meant to be solved a different way? How? How is this supposed to be solved? I fucking got the piece, man. Uh-oh. A new concept that I missed. I mean, I'm gonna reset. Use the jammer. Which sentry? Put the box on top of the sentry, remove the jammer, and let the sentry carry it down for you. Jam it again at the other end. Oh. What? Thank you. Gotcha. I wouldn't have figured that out. Straight up. I wasn't even thinking about that. Just like that. Sweet. Wait. Oh, Capra King, you gonna take it easy? Later, bud. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for hanging out with us today. So, when that robot was running, did Elohim kill him or something? I only saw him running. I didn't see anything else. And then Elohim was like, he didn't do what I wanted him to do. I made a box float. Seriously, it was... Oh. If I had seen this, maybe I had would have thought. Frogs are people too. Schmeckle commodities. Just open a game like Candy Crush that the game's not for you. That's funny. That's funny. Window through a door. This one real quick. I don't want to forget it. Oh, I mean, I didn't know Elohim killed him. All I saw was some blue thing running and it was screaming. I literally saw like half a second of it. And it kind of creeped me out a little bit. Like, it gave me goosebumps. Oh, I see. Thank you. more. Yeah, unfortunately I did mess up a few times on concept introduction. That makes the puzzle significantly more difficult, to solving incorrectly at that. Yeah, I mean, I solved it incorrectly, but I solved it. Cheers, chat. Boom. How great. How great is this? We're solving puzzles together. Boom. We're done. We got the star in this area. Like, it's over. Alright, we're done. We're done with this area. It only took us 30-45 minutes. Oof. Number one is done. One and done. Sweet. Fully complete too.